I want you all to know that I will not make a review for a product unless I actually use it and test its capabilities. I feel that as a reviewer, I carry the responsibility to be fair in regards to how I test a product and honest in what I say about it. So, with that said, here is a disclaimer. XP Pen did not sponsor this video. They just sent this product for me for the purpose of review. I simply reached out to them asking to review this product. Anyways, let's talk the Artist 24 Pro. ...24-inch display, 1440p resolution, 20 express keys, and two of my favorite little red dials and a pen holder. Wow, I really don't even know where to start with this thing. Okay, let's get some basic facts down so you can understand this thing a little better, and then I'll go over what I like, what I don't like, and some feedback I have for this product. This pen display currently retails for $900 US, and with a price tag like that, we're not talking an entry-level pen display. This is their highest-end digital art solution aimed at professionals. Not saying that as a beginner, this would be a bad choice, but when you're starting out, it's not always necessary to have something of this caliber. Although, I will say that a few of you responded to my poll last month, saying that you would spend under $1,000 on your first drawing tablet, so I guess it's for you guys too. First of all, let's talk about why these massive displays are attractive to artists and other creative professionals. This is a 24-inch IPS, non-laminated, more on that later, 1440p display. So you might be thinking, oh, that's not that big. But trust me, it's huge. The reason it seems bigger than a regular 24-inch monitor is that while using this thing for drawing, sculpting, or any other pen-related work, your eyes are actually very close to the screen, unlike when you use a standard monitor. For example, both of these displays on my desk are the same size, 24 inches diagonally. The difference with my monitor on the shelf here is that I'm usually sitting a whole 2 feet away from it while I'm using it, and from that distance it seems like a really, you know, good size monitor. But with the 24 Pro, while drawing at least, I'm quite literally right up against it. My hand is even usually on the side, activating the express keys, so from that distance, a 24-inch monitor is huge. And as a digital artist, it's just so satisfying to use one of these giant displays because it allows you to see the actual scale of whatever you're drawing. You see, using a small display tablet, I can set my canvas size to something huge and then paint something huge. But when viewing the image, it's always gonna look small because my literal screen is just smaller. But with a tablet of this size, you can really see just how big what you're drawing is. What's more is that you don't always have to zoom in to add details since the image is just bigger on your screen. Now, you can definitely do fine with a smaller tablet, but it's really a different experience to draw, animate, and paint on these larger ones. With all that said, how does this thing do as a large pen display? Well, let's start with the specs of the display itself. Like I mentioned earlier, it's a 24-inch 1440p IPS display. It has the capability to show 90% of the Adobe RGB color space. Covering the display is a matte finish, and unlike its predecessors in the Artist series, this screen is not laminated. That means that the gap between your pen and the actual mouse cursor is going to be just a bit bigger. Here's a comparison between the Artist 12 Pro, which does have a laminated screen, and the Artist 24 Pro, which doesn't. Overall, the display is great. It's super sharp even when you're looking very close to it, and it feels just as premium as it looks. Next, let's talk about the build quality. We have an all-plastic construction which feels very solid, and it's quite heavy, so do be careful when handling it. And speaking of handling it, this thing is huge. This thing is really huge. It's just under 25 inches horizontally, so your desk setup will have to make some changes. When I'm drawing with this, I set my keyboard to the left and use the express keys to import shortcuts instead. Let's take a look at the adjustable stand that comes pre-installed on it. I believe the actual foot of the stand is made out of metal, it's very solid, and it has thick rubber feet at the bottom, so it's sturdy and it will not slide around your desk while you're using it. That's really good. You can adjust the height by clenching the handle at the top and lifting or lowering the tablet in the position that you want it. And this is where I start to have a problem. This stand just isn't sufficient for the size of this tablet. The locking mechanism for the height adjustment is oddly inconsistent, making it so you're never really sure whether it's locked in place or not. Sometimes it'll make a clicking sound, sometimes it won't, sometimes it'll just stay. I don't know. You also might want to use two hands when adjusting the height, especially going downwards. All in all, I implore you to be careful with this, especially if you don't have highly developed biceps like I do, because this item is large, quite heavy, and very delicate. On the bright side though, the actual viewing angles that this thing has to offer are fantastic. It goes from almost vertical to as low as 30 degrees. I like this range of motion because it allows me to use it as a monitor for certain applications and then as a drawing monitor for other applications, and I think it'll work well for a lot of you. I'm going to quickly go over the cable connections because I think they really did a good job with the cables on this. You have the option to have a USB-C to USB-C connection from the tablet to computer, and that is the only cable you're going to need, and that is awesome. If you have a newer laptop that has USB-C, this is going to make your desk setup look extra clean. I just use a standard HDMI and power cable, and I just plug in the USB into a USB type A port using the adapter provided with the 24 Pro. Okay, now for what you all have been waiting for. What is it like to draw on the Artist 24 Pro? Well, to sum it up, it's absolutely awesome. Now, it doesn't feel as smooth or as good to draw on as the Artist 12 Pro because it doesn't have that laminated screen. So the feeling while making strokes with a pen is different, but also nice enough for me not to miss having a laminated screen. Drawing on this feels really good, no issues there. One thing I do notice is that I don't really enjoy the tilt support. There are gaps where the pen will jump between tilting angles, which doesn't really inspire confidence in using this feature reliably or for anything serious. Honestly, I don't really use tilt support, so I prefer to have it deactivated if possible, but while it's here, it's okay. Lastly, regarding the pen and the overall drawing experience, if they could make, even if they have to sell it separately, a bigger, more ergonomic pen, I would click my heels. Don't get me wrong, their standard pen is sufficient and it works great. But when it comes to the way I like to draw, especially the way I draw line art, this standard plastic pen just kind of feels hollow. I would really like to see a thicker, heavier Pro pen from XP Pen. So the drawing experience is great, but what about the Express keys? There's a lot of them and tons of different ways you can combine them. So the driver software is really intuitive and you have so many options for combinations of Express keys. Having two dials is great because you can set the primary dial that you're going to be using to a function that you often perform, such as zoom in. And then you can set the one that you're not going to use as much, which is usually going to be the hand that you have the pen in, to a function that you don't use as often. Maybe you can even set it to brush size because while you're editing the brush size, you're not going to be drawing. Also, I really like the rivets on the Express keys. There's one that's sort of like a dash shape and one that's a dot shape on each set of Express keys. That really helps me find which Express key I'm pressing, especially in this upper left corner right here. That one with the dot is my undo key. And with those little rivets, it makes them really easy to find. So I appreciate that little touch they added. Overall, the drivers and Express keys are awesome. I've always appreciated XP Pen's customizability within their driver software. It's really, really good. The Express keys do pick up fingerprints pretty easily, so if you're a neat freak like me, you'll be wiping them off often. But otherwise, I use them a lot, and they work great. For a $900 premium, top-of-the-line drawing display, what do I like, what don't I like, and what could be improved? Here is what I like. First off, the screen is beautiful. It's very sharp due to that high resolution, which allows you to have more drawing space in your programs, which is so relieving. This is especially true for programs like DaVinci Resolve and OpenTunes because you will always have several different modules or windows open in one given layout. On a 1080p display, these windows will eat up your drawing space, but on a 1440p display, they're smaller so you have more space to work, and I really like that. The drawing experience overall is probably a B+. It feels good and it's easy to work with, but without that laminated screen and the lacking tilt support, I'd say it's not quite perfect, but very good. As for the Express keys, they're great. Animation programs always have a lot of shortcuts, so I find it necessary to have a ton of available Express keys, and I actually use all 20 of these. Here's what I don't like. I don't like the inadequate locking mechanism of the stand. I'm not really sure about this, but I believe it's some sort of serrated lock by the way it feels, which works fine on smaller, less heavy pen displays. However, with these larger, more premium displays, I think it's necessary to find a better way to lock them in place. Here's what I think could be improved. I want a bigger, heavier, more ergonomic pen. Even if they have to sell it separately, I think that'll go a long way to make the drawing experience of XP Pen truly different from its competitors. Also, I just really want to use a heavier pen. Secondly, I hope that someday when this product is updated, maybe as the Innovator 24, wink wink, nudge nudge, that we could see a fully laminated display. I know the price to manufacture it would go up significantly and possibly the retail price as well, but even then I think it would still be a cheaper and more viable option than its 24-inch Wacom counterpart. In conclusion, the Artist 24 Pro is an awesome pen display. I really enjoy drawing on it. The 20 Express keys and two dials speed up my workflow, and with a clean conscience, I can say I recommend buying this product. What do you think? Are you going to invest in this to further your digital art journey? Do you know of a better drawing monitor that's cheaper or even has more features than this one? I don't know. Let me know in the comments section below. Thank you all for watching this so much. I hope it helped you make your decision or just provided you some useful information about the Artist 24 Pro. If you like this video, leave a like. And if you found it helpful, then check out some of my other videos. I make plenty of animation tutorials, reviews, speed paints, you name it. And if you like what you see, consider subscribing so you can see it more often. That's all from me, guys. I'll see you guys next time. Peace. Special thanks to Owen Art for supporting this channel on Patreon. If you want to see the latest news about my film Castle Dark, gain access to exclusive tutorials and behind-the-scenes content, head over to the link below or on the end screen to my Patreon page.